Hi, everyone, and welcome to the Robertson Media Center at the University of Virginia. Today, we're going to talk about DaVinci Resolve, a free professional video editing program we have at the RMC. This video series is intended for beginners, and it only covers enough to get started. For more details, check out the link below. We'll start with a tour of the interface and how to import media. Next, we'll look at basic editing techniques and tools, followed by basic audio, transitions, text, and titles, as well as effects and color correction. And then finally, I'll teach you how to export the final file to TurnIn. DaVinci Resolve is professional software for video editing. While it's more complicated than something like iMovie, it can also do so much more and allows the user complete control over their projects. It may take more time to learn than some consumer level editors, but you'll quickly see why it's so much more powerful. You can use it on Mac, Windows, or Linux, and I highly recommend that you download it on your own computer so you don't have to return to the computer lab to use it. The free version has a few restrictions, including limits on resolution, effects, and certain controls. To get these features, you'll need to purchase the full version. For example, if you wanted to use a higher resolution than UHD, you can't do this in the free version. Also, noise reduction and other advanced effects are restricted. So see the link below if you want to see a full rundown of what isn't included. Let's get started. So if you open DaVinci Resolve, you can see here is the splash page. This is actually called the Project Manager, and we'll return to this a little bit later to do certain things like archiving. But here you can see I have two projects already created, but right here I could create a new one if I selected new project here. That's to create a new project. I can zoom, I can reorder things, I can show more information. This is nice to see what size the resolution is, for instance. And I can choose between the list or the thumbnail versions. And in the thumbnails, you can actually scrub through and see the whole project. Here's my memes project I'll be using. Down here, you can create a new project, a new folder to put your projects in, or you can click open. So again, either new project here, or you can open one of the old ones. I'm gonna open up this meme demo here. So now we're into the program. First, let's take a little bit of a tour of what we have here. If you're not used to a Mac, up top, you can see the menus on top. Here we have close, minimize, and maximize, which makes it full screen. If you're on a PC, of course, these would be over on the right-hand side. And the menus would be slightly different, but most of them are gonna be pretty much the same as you work in this program. So another thing to notice is down on the bottom, there are these tabs down here. These are called workspaces. We're currently in this one called Media. But we'll work probably from the left to the right. So they're kind of set up in order to get your process moving in the proper order. The first one's Media. This is where you import and organize your clips, as you can see here. The next one over is called Cut. And Cut, you can look through and cut down clips to be added to the timeline. Not for detailed edits, for like kind of assembling your edit. The next one is called Edit. And edit is where you can make the detailed edit of your assets in the timeline. This is where we're gonna spend almost all of our time in DaVinci Resolve, is in the edit workspace. The next one is called Fusion. Fusion is for detailed effects and things like that. We'll only spend a little bit of time in here. It's really much more for advanced users. The next one is color correction and color grading. This is where you can adjust the color in your project, which DaVinci Resolve is particularly well known for. And then following that is something called Fairlight. That's where your detailed audio editing and final mixing will take place. We won't spend a whole lot of time in here either, because most of what you can do, you can also do in the edit workspace, just in a more fine-tuned kind of detailed version here. And then the last one is called Deliver. Deliver is where you're going to export your final project. You have a render queue. You can add all the things to the queue and then render them or export them. Okay, but we're going to actually return to the edit workspace. Again, the third one down here. Edit. This is where we're going to spend most of our time in the program. Everything else is kind of specifically for specific tasks. This is for editing. So once we come back later and create a new project and import our footage, we'll actually return here to do most of our working. So you'll notice that there are kind of a few different windows here. And if you're used to a nonlinear editing program, these should look fairly familiar. The one I'll start with is over here. This is your media pool. You can turn on and off with the media pool button. And this is all of your assets that you've imported earlier in your media workspace, or you can import them here. So you can see I have, all these different things, and you can scroll through them and see what you have. So here's my Rickroll, and then you can see I've used a certain amount of it. So that little orange that you can see on here is the amount I've used of this clip in my timeline. So you can see what I've used and what I haven't used based on this here over in the media pool. Following up to the right, you can see that there is two different preview windows. The first one is this preview window for watching things in your media pool. And then the one on the right is your preview of your timeline. So this is previewing before it goes into the timeline. And then this one is watching the final product that I have edited here in the timeline. Both of these windows have a lot of the same tools. So you can see here's a loop button. You have play, stop, backwards, right? And you can skip around. You also have this, which you can slide back and forth to watch in your timeline. Or if you have a particular thing, double click it and you can scroll back and forth. So let me get a video so that looks better here. And I can watch back and forth in time if that's a little easier for you to use. Down at the bottom, I have my timeline and my tools up top. And down here, you have the video and audio tracks. You can think about the timeline as being divided by this double line here down the center. And that is separating your audio from your video. As you can see, I have several layers of video on top, and I have several layers of audio underneath. And they are numbered here, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And you can see that they're divided, but at the same time, when I select things that have audio that go with them, I select them, they are linked together, the audio and video together. That's so that, for instance, with this intro recording where I'm talking, the audio and video don't become unsynced. So this is the playhead. So if I move it to the beginning, it's at 0. If I select here, you can see that I'm 16 seconds into the project. So it starts at 0 and moves onward. As long as the project is, it goes on and on. You can see that they are numbered here for the duration of the project. If I slide this little slider or I hit the plus and minus here, I can zoom in and out on that timeline. So you can see my timeline now is 2 minutes and 22 seconds long, according to where the playhead is here. To watch, you can either hit this little play button up in the preview window, or you can press the spacebar. And spacebar to stop. And as you can see, it pauses where I stopped with the spacebar. As I click and drag, I can pull it around and look at what's happening at any particular moment in the video. And so you just grab it and pull it. Or you can select up in this area. But if you select down here, it won't do anything. So you got to select it up in this time code up here. Sometimes when you're zooming in and out, you're thinking, oh, I just want to see the whole thing. So if you click here, full extent zoom, that's going to zoom out and fit your entire project to the frame. If you want to look at a closer detail, you can click detail zoom, and it's going to zoom in, and you can just click back and forth between these two to get a good sense. You can see that when I click on detail zoom, it's wherever I put my playhead. So if I'm on keyboard cat, I can select this and it zooms in on the place I am in the keyboard cat. And then I can select the full extent zoom to zoom back out to the full project. Over on the left hand side, you can see you can turn on and off a layer using this little film frame here to kind of view or turn off. Same here with mute and solo on the audio tracks. Mute, of course, is turning off a particular layer temporarily, or solo is turning off every other layer so you can listen to that particular layer. So you do that, and then the rest of them will be muted. And then you could lock. So if you wanted to say, oh, I don't want to make any changes to any of these videos on this layer here, you can lock that layer, and then you can't actually change any of the video that happens on that layer. Often you will want to expand your layers themselves. If I click and drag, you can see now I can see the actual waveform in the audio. And I can do the same thing with the video here. If you wanted to change what you can see there, there's actually a whole set of timeline view options, which includes, you know, seeing a kind of a what is in there versus not. But if you'd like to see what videos are where, you can switch your different view options. So let's say I want to create a new project and I want to open this one. I want to start fresh. So what I'll do is I'll go back to the project manager. If you go to File, Project Manager, you can see that this is the main splash page that you had before. This is where you'll probably be creating most of your new projects. You can also go to File, New Project as well, but this way you can see it. So instead of selecting my meme demo, I'm going to click New Project. I don't want to save that. So I'm going to name it. Let's say Test 1. Name it whatever your project is, of course, and click Create. And now I have an empty project. The first thing I want to do is actually return. So remember the workspace is down at the bottom. I'm going to return to the media workspace. And this is where I can go to my media storage and find all of the clips that I want to import in. So once I've found over on the far left side, I've found the media that I want. I can just drag that in and here we go. I've got all the media imported. It's that easy. You can also, you know, right click and say import media. I'll go to file, import file, right? But the easiest thing is actually just to drag it and drop it. So you can find it in here, or you could go into your Finder window and drag it and drop it in. Rather than kind of selecting individual files to bring in, you can bring in whole folders. So I have them all right here that I drag and drop in. One more step before I leave this workspace, I'm gonna go over to the bottom right. You see this little gear here that says Project Settings? If I select that, then I can look at my timeline format. This is extremely important because DaVinci Resolve automatically creates your file for you. You just want to make sure that it's correct. So in this situation, actually, it isn't, because what I want to do is go to 30 frames per second and keep my playback time the exact same. And my video format, go to 1080p, 30 frames per second. Since I'm downloading stuff from the internet and I recorded my video at 30 frames per second, I just want to make sure that that matches my file format. Timeline format. You can see here there's whole resolutions you can select. The most common actually is what it automatically default creates, which is 1920 by 1080, which is technically high definition or HD. And then you just need to select what your frames per second are. If you have a different kind of project or a different kind of camera than I've used, it's potentially going to be a different resolution size. And this is where you can see that Ultra HD is the largest I can go in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. If you wanted to go to true 4K, you would need the full version of DaVinci Resolve. And that's right, so I'm going to click Save. I can't emphasize how important it is to make sure that you select the correct project settings right off the bat before you even start editing. A couple things to note, if you're doing stop motion, you will need to have your files in numerical order, and then it will automatically detect them. So here's an example. You can see I have a page turn stop motion animation that I want to bring in, and it has already detected that it is stop motion. So there's an image sequence that's in numerical order, and you'll notice it doesn't have to start with one. Another thing to notice, unlike Premiere, for instance, there are certain file types that this program can't open, one of which I run into more often is probably a GIF, GIF. Those types of files are often not supported. So just make sure that you can find all the files that you're supposed to have in your media pool down here. One final thing to point out before I move on, DaVinci Resolve doesn't gather all of your media for you. It links out to the media. So if you've ever used something like iMovie, iMovie brings all of the media that you're going to use into one folder that you can take with you, which is really convenient, but professional software often doesn't do that for you. So I'll point out that the project file itself does not include any of the actual videos or photos or audio that you've imported into the project. And if you were to just transfer this to a different computer, or if you deleted some of the media that you had downloaded or that you had recorded, they will become unlinked and you will be out of luck unless you can find those files again to relink them. So make sure you have a kind of a tidy folder that includes all of the different media that you're going to be using. So I have it here. So here's the project file. And then media files, I have audio, right? I have all of the different photos that I'm going to use, all of the video downloads. Everything's all in one folder that I can, you know that everything's going to stay where it is. So none of it's in the downloads folder or directly on the desktop, because those things will become unlinked, and you will lose your progress. One way to make sure, which I've done here, that you have done that is actually to create an archive. So let's say you've worked for a while and then you either want to transfer it to a different computer or that you want to, you know, make sure that you can return to it without losing any linked media. If you go back to your project manager after saving this project, just make sure you save as often as possible. I'm going to go to project manager. And then I can right click on this project and go to export project archive. And then I can select the location and click save. And here you click OK. And it's going to create an archive file wherever you chose that you can open up and be sure that you can, you know, use all of the media that you want. To restore, you come back to this project manager. I'll close, I'll show you that again. File, project manager. You can right click and say restore project archive, and then you select this, and then you know that you have an archived version of this somewhere on your computer that you have, hopefully remember where it is, or you can transfer that to somebody else so they can continue editing this project. Click close. Which reminds me, saving. There are two types of saving when you're working on a video project. The first type of saving is when you go to file, save, or save project as. That's going to create a work file that once again links out to the media, doesn't include the media, so it can become unlinked. And that's the file you're going to return to if you want to keep editing. That is not the file that you are going to turn in at the end. That is exporting. So if you come down here, you can see export project, a quick export. That's also over in the delivery workspace, or deliver workspace that we will get to a little bit later. But when you click file, save project as, just make sure that you save it in a good location. Okay, so coming up next, we'll be talking about basic editing. We'll go through the tools and techniques you need to know in DaVinci Resolve. Stay with us.